majesty, manhood and deity, in perfect harmony, the man who is God, Lord of eternity, dwells in humanity, kneels in humility, and washes our feet. Oh, what a mystery, meekness and majesty, bow down and worship, for this is your God, this is your God, oh, your God. Father's pure radiance, perfect in innocence, yet learns obedience to death on a cross, suffering to give us life, conquering through sacrifice, and as they crucify, praise Father, forgive. Oh, what a mystery, meekness and majesty, bow down and worship, for this is your God, this is your God. Unsearchable, God the invisible, love indestructible, in frailty appears. Lord of infinity, stooping so tenderly, lifts our humanity to the heights of His throne. Oh, what a mystery, meekness and majesty, for this is your God, this is your God, this is your God.
To our worship this morning, to those taking part and to those listening to the recording. Sadly, a few days ago, I had to inform you all of the sudden passing of Tom Truscott. Tom was a kind and gentle man with a strong faith. Though he and Anne have not been able to return to church since reopening, this year they have been able to receive home communion. Though only members of St Mary's congregation for a relatively short time, we are thankful that we have been able to be part of Tom's latter years and for the memories we have of him. We will continue to hold Tom and his family in our prayers. Work in church has progressed rapidly this week, with the bare walls of last week now covered with the base layers of rough plaster, ready for the finer top layer to be applied in the next 2 weeks. As today's video shows, the dust levels just continue to grow, and the look of our church becomes more of a building site by the day. Today's gospel reading is one of the most popular and loved parables, the story of the Good Samaritan, the story we all learned and remember being taught in Sunday school, the story of the Jewish man on his way from Jerusalem to Jericho, being beaten and left for dead, only to be passed by not once but twice by the two very people who should have given him the help he needed. It was the man from Samaria who was least likely to offer that help that did so willingly and at a cost to himself. There was fractions between the Jews and the Samaritans. They were not the best of friends, but he did not allow that prejudice to stop him from helping the beaten, injured man. But why did Jesus find it necessary to tell this parable? He was simply responding to the lawyer's question, "What must I do to inherit eternal life?" He knew he had to follow God's commandments of loving God and his neighbour as himself. But he continued to question who his neighbour was. With all that is happening in the world today, this story has never been more relevant. Let us come together to sing God's praises, to hear God's word, and to bring our prayers for the coming week.
Collect for the fourth Sunday after Trinity. O God, the protector of all who trust in you, without whom nothing is strong, nothing is holy, increase and multiply upon us your mercy, that with you as our ruler and guide we may so pass through things temporal that we lose not our hold on things eternal. Grant this, Heavenly Father, for our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
I'm unmuted.
Yeah.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. And the Lord your God will make you abundantly prosperous in all your undertakings, in the fruit of your body in the fruit of your livestock and in the fruit of your soil. For the Lord will again take delight in prospering you, just as he delighted in prospering your ancestors. When you obey the Lord your God by observing his commandments and decrees that are written in this book of law, because you turn to the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. Exhortation to choose life. Surely this commandment that I'm commanding you today is not too hard for you, nor is it too far away. It's not in heaven that you should say, who will go up to heaven for us and get it for us so that we may hear it and observe it? Neither is it beyond the sea that you should say, who will cross to the other side of the sea for us and get it for us so that we may hear it and observe it? No, the word is very near to you. It is in your mouth and in your heart for you to observe.
A reading from the letter to Paul to the Colossians. I, Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus, by the will of God, and Timothy, our brother, to the saints and faithful brothers and sisters in Christ in Colossae, grace to you and peace from God our Father. In our prayers for you, we always thank God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. For we have heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of the love that you have for all the saints. Because of the hope laid upon you in heaven, you have heard of this hope before in the word of the truth, the gospel that has come to you. Just as it is bearing fruit and growing in the whole world, so it has been bearing fruit amongst yourselves from the day you heard it and truly comprehended the grace of God. This you learned from Epaphras, our beloved fellow servant. He is a faithful minister of Christ on our behalf, and he has made known to us your love in the Spirit. For this reason, since the day we heard it, we have not ceased praying for you and asking that you be filled with the knowledge of God's will in all spiritual wisdom and understanding, so that you may walk worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing to him as you bear fruit in every good work and as you grow in the knowledge of God. May you be made strong with all the strength that comes from the glorious power, so that you may have all endurance and patience joyfully, giving thanks to the Father, who has enabled you to share in the inheritance of the saints in the light. He has rescued us from the power of darkness and transferred us into the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins.
reading from the Gospel according to Luke. An expert in the law stood up to test Jesus. "Teacher," he said, "what must I do to inherit eternal life?" He said to him, "What is written in the law? What do you read there?" He answered, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, and with all your mind, and your neighbour as yourself." And Jesus said to him, "You have given the right answer. Do this, and you will live." But wanting to vindicate himself, he asked Jesus, "And who is my neighbour?" Jesus replied, "A man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell into the hands of robbers, who stripped him, beat him, and took him off, leaving him half dead. Now by chance, a priest was going down the road, and when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. So likewise a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, while travelling, came upon him, and when he saw him, he was moved with compassion. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, treating him with oil and wine. Then he put him on his own animal, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day, he took out 2 denarii, gave them to the innkeeper, and said, 'Take care of him, and when I come back, I will repay you whatever more you spend.' Which of these three do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell upon the hands of the robber?" he said. "The one who showed him mercy." Jesus said, "Go and do likewise."
The Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead, and on the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Reach out and touch. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we give thanks that despite all that the past week has brought, events in our own lives, in our communities, in the world, and the work in our church that sees us once again in our own homes, we can still come together through the power of technology to sing your praise and worship in your name. We ask you to bless us with patience and strength as we deal with the disruption we face as the work in St. Mary's continues. And we pray that the work is completed safely and effectively, and in the hope that we can soon be back in church while we wait for the plaster to dry. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Father, today we ask for wisdom and guidance for our leaders faced with many challenges at this time. Help them to put aside political gain and self-interest to work honourably and diligently for the genuine good of the people they serve. We continue to bring before you the people of Ukraine and Russia as we hear of the abuse of human rights in both countries. We ask your blessings on the work of all those involved in the relief operation and for all those working for peace, justice, and reconciliation throughout the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Father of love, we pray for our families, friends, and neighbours, and give thanks for the love, kindness, and friendship we've experienced this week. We pray in particular for the vulnerable within our communities, especially those who are struggling to make ends meet. We pray for wisdom and compassion for those in authority, locally and nationally, as they make difficult decisions affecting others. We for our young people, also for our young people, their families and teachers, as the end of the school year approaches and they begin to look to the holidays as a time of refreshment. We pray for those of our own congregation away on holiday at this time, that they too may return renewed. We give thanks for the work of our messy church, for the work Suzanne Bridges has shared with us, and ask for your blessing as she moves to work in other areas. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Father, we pray for those who are sick in body, mind, or spirit. We particularly bring before you Father Rodney, Joyce Adamson, Mavis and Brian Walsh, Anne Truscott, Peter Smith, Stephen Dander, and Sally, and any we wish to pray for ourselves today. We pray today for Andy Foreman, taken seriously ill on holiday, for him and for his wife Sarah, coping in a foreign country. We pray for those suffering from COVID as a number spike and the difficulty this is causing to our medical support services. We continue to pray for strength and support for the staff and residents in our care homes and for those working in our local hospitals and health services. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Father of hope, today remember all those who have gone before us. We pray for those who have died recently. Especially, we pray for Tom Truscott, who passed away suddenly this week. We remember him as a kind and caring gentleman who showed interest and concern for those around him. A gentleman whose devout faith was lived in his everyday life. A gentleman ever ready in his quiet and assuming way to draw others to that same faith and welcome them into the church. A gentleman who loved and was loved by his family. We pray for those whose anniversaries are around this time, as well as any we wish to bring before you ourselves today. We thank you for their love, friendship, and for our memories of them. We pray for Anne, Lizzie, Sarah, Olivia, and all Tom's family, and for all who mourn the loss of a loved one. We pray they find the comfort and strength they need. Finally, remembering God's gift of eternal life, we ask that they may rest in peace and rise in glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
In a moment of silence, we bring our own prayers to God. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.